Good morning, students. So we had been discussing about the structure of atom. In that we had seen all the contemporary models given by various scientists like Dalton, Rutherford, Niels Bohr. Today we will be seeing Planck's quantum atomic model. Okay, or Planck's quantum theory. Planck's quantum model. This is similar to that of Bohr's atomic theory, and it says that when electron gains energy, it goes to higher orbit. Second, when electron loses energy, it comes down to lower orbit. On doing so, the energy absorbed for going to absorb to go to higher orbit or energy lost due to falling of electron to lower orbit is in the form of packets of energy or packets of light energy. Which is proportional to the frequency of the light. So energy is proportional to frequency of the light, and it can be equated by a constant called as Planck's constant H nu, and nu can be written as speed of light by wavelength of the light. So E can be written as E is equal to hc by lambda. So he said that energy released is not continuous, but discontinuous packets. Of energy. It was found true when the spectral lines of the hydrogen atom spectra was observed. When the spectral lines of hydrogen atom spectra was observed, then the following lines of transitions were seen. Now, how to draw the hydrogen spectra? Hydrogen spectra. Spectra means what? Band of light. Okay, spectra means band of light. Various types of lights of various energies. So what we will do? We will draw 7 energy levels. This is n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, n equal to 4, n equal to 5, 6 and say it is 7. What are these lines? These lines are nothing but the energy levels, like first orbit, second orbit, third orbit, fourth orbit, fifth orbit, sixth orbit and seventh orbit. So it is just widened to make our understanding easy. Now what happens? Let us name it as n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, n equal to 4, n equal to 5, n equal to 6 and n equal to 7. So if the electron falls from energy level 7, so how it can fall? It can fall from 7 to 1. It can fall from 6 to 1. It can fall from 5 to 1. It can fall from 4 to 1. Then 3 to 1. And 2 to 1. So the wavelength associated with these transitions would be n1 will be 1 and n2 will be, the highest will be 7. So we can write this as 1 by lambda will be equal to Rydberg constant 1 by n1 square is 1 square minus 1 by 7 square. Where for n1 we can write n1 equal to 1. So if you are asked to find out the wave number of transition of electrons, if you are asked to find out the wave number of transition of electrons from or in the first series, then we will find it out in this way. This series is called as Lyman series or Lyman series. Lyman, L-Y M-A-L-L. Then after that what can happen is the electrons can fall from 7 to 2, from 7 to energy level 2. Okay. Six to two, five to two, four to two, three to two. This will be called as Balmer series. All the visible colors are seen in this series. Balmer series. After that, from n equal to 7 to n equal to 3. This will be called as Pascal series. Next is from n equal to 7 to n equal to 4. This is called as bracket series. and after that n equal to 7 to n equal to 5. So see, the electrons are not falling directly or continuously, they are coming step by step, isn't it? They are coming like steps. That is why they form discontinuous packets of energy which can be related with this wave number. So if you are asked to find out the wave number for any series, then N2 will be the highest one. Okay, and the N1 will always be equal to where it is falling. Okay, so say if you are asked to find out the wave number for Balmer series, then you will take N1 will be 2 and N2 will be any of the lines. Like say if somebody says first line, then you will take 7, second line, then you will take 6, third line, then you will take 5, so on and so forth. Okay, so here this represents the first line from 7 to 1. Okay, so first line of Balmer, for first line of Balmer we will take N1 equal to 2 and the N higher will be equal to 7 for the first line, but for the second line we will take 6. Okay, so higher one we will take this side, lower one we will take that side. So this was about hydrogen spectra and Planck's quantum model. And how do we find out the energy or the wave number? Energy or the wave number, wavelength, reciprocal of wavelength is wave number, and it is found by Rydberg constant, the value of which is nothing but 109677 per centimeter, 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. So for layman, N1 will be 1, for Balmer N1 will be equal to 2, for Pascal N1 will be equal to 3, for bracket N1 will be equal to 3, and for, this is called as Fund series, although we write one P over here, but we call it as Fund series. For Fund series, N1 will be equal to 4, and for the first line, it will be equal to 7. 7, 7, 7, 7. Now if you are asked, if somebody asks that why fourth line is not possible in P or in Fund series, then you can simply say that the number of transitions possible are 3 only. Like from here to here, from 7 to 4, from 6 to 4, and from 5 to 4. So only these transitions are possible in case of Fund series. And hence, fourth line is not possible. Alright. So, in this way, you can explain. Now, what mistake is here? This should go here. Alright. So, only two spectral lines are possible for P fund. Or Fund series, we call it Fund series, not P fund. Three lines, spectral lines are possible for bracket series. Four transitions and four lines are possible for Pascal series. So on and so forth. And once we can find out the wave number, we can find out the energy also. Okay. So this is the schematic diagram to express the hydrogen spectra. Agar aise pucha jaye ki wave number nikalo first transition of Balmer series ka, to N1 lenge 1 aur N2 lenge 7. सेकेंड ट्रांजिशन सीरीज का, ठीक है, मतलब सेकेंड लाइन का लेमन सीरीज का, सेकेंड लाइन ऑफ लेमन सीरीज, तो N1 कितना रहेगा, N1 रहेगगा 1 ही, और N2 हो जाएगा 6, ठीक है। तो इस प्रकार से हम क्विकली एक रफ डायग्राम ड्रॉ कर सकते हैं, और रफ डायग्राम ड्रॉ करके हम 1 बाई लेमडा का वैल्यू निकाल सकते हैं। यहाँ पे पर सेंटीमीटर में आएगा ये। So now next we will be seeing little bit of, now we will be wrapping up the chapter, and then what we will be doing is we will practice those topics of this chapter which are required for rest of the chapters to be easy. Okay, like filling up of the electron in the subsequent atomic orbitals in SPDF method. Although I had made a previous video, but I will make a fresh one. Alright, because I had seen that video, the quality of that was not that good. Okay, so I'll make it once again and I will try to explain or wrap up the whole chapter once again in the next video. Thank you.